Now for our first short shot, we're going to talk about the Super Bowl and commercials. And really, I watch the Super Bowl for the commercials. I'm one of those people that will fast forward through the game and like, oh, there's a game happening too. But the ads are what do it for me.
Yeah, I'm the same way. I watch with a group of people who could care less about the game, except for the Puppy Bowl. Sometimes you watch the Puppy Bowl.
And the Kids Bowl.
And then click over to watch the ads. Do you feel like this year's crop of ads was generally more somber than I have seen in years past?
Robyn, there was an ad where a kid dies, literally.
Yeah, I mean, really, I don't understand that at all.
Nationwide killed a kid. They were like, this kid will never get married, will never do this, because he's dead. And it's just like, what are you, it's the Super Bowl, what are you guys doing?
No, it was completely horrific. Nissan also had an ad about like an absent father and
with, like Cats in the Cradle playing.
Yeah.
Like, the whole song of Cats in the Cradle.
Right, right. Okay, so we don't like that. We don't like neglectful parents
or dead
children.
I was sick of all the dad ads. There was too many dad ads this year.
But then there are the horses. I mean, I would watch, if I had a TV, which I don't right now, I would watch the Super Bowl ads only for the Clydesdales.
Yeah.
Well, they've had this running theme of like a dog falling in love with a horse, which, I mean, I'm no biblical scholar, but that doesn't sound right.
I mean, the world is so cynical in itself. I mean, just with the news and the stories, we need the horse and the puppy.
On the animal tip, there was a really great commercial from GSD&M this year, locally produced, that avocados from Mexico, and there is this great shot where they're like drafting animals for different countries.
Yeah, remind me of Dave Chappelle's racial draft from back in the day, which is why I think it was so clever. And it was also the first time fresh produce has advertised during the Super Bowl.
Oh, really?
Yay,
there was a polar bear with a sombrero like, that is the best.
Polar bears for the win. How did we feel about the retro everything? The Brady Bunch and Machete.
That was great.
Mashup.
Was great.
I loved that Today Show Discovers the Internet.
That was weird, yeah.
I loved it.
Was that a real
In 1994.
Segment?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that was pretty cool.
That was, he's come around.
I saw that one on the web. I thought that was pretty weird. I mean, Brian Gumbo. he really morphed. In the intervening years there.
Celebrities are always the thing at the Super Bowl. There was a great Liam Neeson ad for a mobile game that was fantastic.
Yes.
Liam Neeson, like, going aggro on somebody in a mobile game.
Yeah, it was interesting uses of celebrities' own personas. I thought Mindy Kaling's ad about being invisible and then that invisibility turning into a superpower.
With Matt Damon was
a clever twist. And I will say that I actually had hope for the Kim Kardashian T-Mobile hotspot ad, but it didn't quite reach comedic heights, and maybe I should stop having such high expectations of Kim Kardashian.
Maybe you should lower your expectations of Kim Kardashian.
In general.
Just tiny
hair.
Notch. There were a lot of inspirational ads. McDonald's had acts of kindness. There was a With Dad ad with the hashtag. Microsoft did a commercial that was pretty inspirational. So there was a lot of like trying to make you feel something, but I still could not get over that Nationwide ad with a dead kid. Like,
yeah,
that ruined.
Yeah, no, I was pretty emotionally traumatized after that. But we'll be linking to some of our favorite commercials on our show page. So listeners, come talk to us on Twitter. I feel like we all need to get our feelings out about Super Bowl ads.
I have thoughts.
Yeah, let's come together. Twitter.com/statesmanshots.